be not deceived. In Matthew chapter 24, verse 4, Jesus tells us one of the things we must pay attention to if we want to succeed in our spiritual life and in our ministry and eventually arrive in heaven. That scripture says, "And Jesus answered and said unto them, Take heed that no man deceive you." Now, when someone tells you to take heed, that means you should be careful, be vigilant, beware, be cautious, look out, watch out, or think twice. When Jesus said his disciples should be careful so that no man would deceive them, he was saying they should be careful so that no man would mislead, trick, lie to, swindle, or misinform them. Of course, he's giving the same warning to those of us who belong to him today. We want to consider here some of the men and women you have to be careful of so that they don't misinform and make you miss it with the Lord. Among them are people who are always singing your praise. It is not bad for us to speak encouraging words to our pastors and other brethren who are laboring fervently in the Lord. Every now and again, we need to let them know how much we appreciate them, because such words have a way of strengthening and challenging them to go on. But you need to be careful of people who want to make you feel too important. People who will tell you that you are the best pastor, deacon, bishop, and so on that they have ever come across. People who will always tell you that you are the best Sunday school teacher your church has ever had. Those who will tell you that your voice is so sweet and anointed that when you are not singing with the rest of the choir, the Spirit of God does not come down. Those who will tell you that that prayer meetings are boring without you, but when you lead prayers, the building literally shakes. Those who want you to believe that whenever you are not around, nothing works. The reason why you have to be careful of these people is that the kind of words they speak to you might make you begin to go contrary to Paul's admonition in Romans chapter 12 verse 3. "For I say, through the grace given unto me, to every man that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly, according as God hath dealt to every man the measure of faith." Then you become full of pride and finally bring yourself to a point where God begins to resist you, according to 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 5. Understand that among these praise singers, there are those who are sincere and really want to make you understand how much they appreciate what the Lord is doing in their life through you. There are also those who are like the Pharisees in Matthew chapter 22, who took counsel to see how they might entangle our Lord Jesus in his speech. And then verse 16 says, "And they sent unto him their disciples with the Herodians, saying, Master, we know that thou art truth, and teachest the word of God in truth. Neither carest thou for any man, for thou regardest not the person of men." Then verse 18 says that Jesus perceived their wickedness, and he called them hypocrites. Be wise in handling praises, whether they are given with sincerity or with a wicked desire to make you fall. Do not allow them to take root in your heart, so that you don't begin to take the place of the Lord and share in his glory. Take heed that no man deceive you. Another set of people you should be careful of are those who want you to believe the worst of yourself. People who do not see any good thing in you and are always seizing every opportunity to criticize and condemn you. These are people who have the same kind of attitude as Nathanael, who said in John chapter 1 verse 46, "Can there any good thing come out of Nazareth?" These brethren will look for an opportunity to let you know that when Sister A is leading praise and worship, they are blessed far more than when you do it. They want you to know that Brother B is a better intercessor or quotes the scriptures better than you during Sunday school. Among these people too, you have those who will not talk to you directly, but will make subtle remarks to your hearing just to hurt and put you down. You also have those who will speak discouraging words to you in jest or with seriousness. The reason why you have to beware of this kind of people is that if you take their words to heart, you might begin to see yourself as a failure, and then you give up, and of course, if you do that, you end up not accomplishing the task that the Lord has given to you. You might not be able to quote the Bible like the next person. You might not be the chorister with the sweetest voice. You might not be the pastor with the best sermon, but the Bible says that you should not let anyone despise your youth. All that God is asking from you is that you make yourself available and walk as the Spirit directs you. Stay on his word, seek his face in prayer and fasting, and give him preeminence in every area of your life. He will be the one to fill and lift you as he chooses. Take heed that no man deceive you. Finally, you have to take heed that you do not deceive your own self. Many Christians are in the habit of comparing themselves to others, and so they either begin to get swollen-headed when they convince themselves that they are better than everyone else, or they begin to despair when they think they are inferior to the rest of the people. The Bible says that it is not wise to compare yourself with other people. Stop measuring yourself against other people's success. You are accountable to God as an individual. The amount of grace that he has invested in you may not be the same as the one he gave to your neighbor, so there is no basis for comparison. Remember the servants that Jesus talked about in Matthew chapter 25. One of them got 5 talents from his master, another got two, while the third got one. Find out from the Lord what he has given to you and what he expects you to do with it. Then focus your attention on accomplishing his will and leave your neighbor to do the same. God is taking each of your children somewhere. Take heed and let nobody, including yourself, deceive and cause you to derail. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name.